Doma Sports Talk, worldwide, with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, you got a pretty big fight coming this weekend, right? Between Canelo Alvarez, which some consider the face of boxing, which some consider the number one pound for pound, versus Billy Joe Saunders, the undefeated two-time, two-division weight champion, 160-pound champion, 168-pound champion. Has discipline issues, but when he's on, he's a good fighter. If you don't believe me, look at his fight when he fought David Lemieux, beat him real bad. Canelo Alvarez at that point was like, shoot, we ain't fighting him, he's a runner. We'll get to that in a minute. But throughout the world right now, you know, it's a couple of legendary things about to pop off. Keep your eye on Formula One with Lewis Hamilton versus Max Verstappen. I'm just going to mention that because this is about to be a historic type of thing. But I'm going to do an extra video about it, but it's about to be historic. It's going to rival some of the great rivals in Formula One history like Michael Schumacher versus Jacques Villeneuve, or Michael Schumacher versus Mika Häkkinen. I won't give it the Alan Prost Art and Center treatment yet, because Max Verstappen doesn't have a title yet. But if he did, in terms of what they're going to be doing, the cars are pretty much level, and these guys, Max Verstappen, don't you know, take a back seat to nobody. We know Lewis Hamilton doesn't. And at the end of the day, Lewis Hamilton is also going for this eighth title, which would be a record in Formula One history. Check that out. Another historical thing that people don't want to talk about in the NBA, but the hell with what they want to talk about, is Russell Westbrook. Russell Westbrook just gave us last night, what did he give us? 21 rebounds, 24 assists. You know, history. 24 is the most in Washington Wizards history, and it's tied his best. And 21 rebounds for a guard is ridiculous anyway, right? He's already averaging 11.2, which no guard has probably in history either. You know what I mean? So keep your eye on that. Don't let them tell you not to, because they got you watching all these people to just shoot three-point shots and they can't be contested. Focus on what you're seeing. That's legendary. The rest of it's just, hey, the NBA is telling people to shoot threes all day. That's not what Russell Westbrook is doing. He's not a good three-point shooter, and his assists are not even going to three-point shooters. They're going to different people in the lane. It's incredible. So anyway, back to boxing. You know, Canelo Alvarez and your boy, Billy Joe Saunders. Billy Joe Saunders is threatening to walk away from the damn fight, right? And I'm going to tell you, I hope he does, and I hope he does at the last minute. Right, and I'm going to tell you why I hope he does at the last minute. Because there's expected to be 70,000 people coming, and I hope, unfortunately, that the people come first. Right? Because I've seen with Canelo Alvarez, no one has, bam, there's no empathy. So maybe something has to happen to some people, right, themselves, for them to get disgruntled. Like driving there with your kids to the damn fight, and then Canelo has done something that Billy Joe Saunders does not like. And then Billy Joe Saunders pulls out at the last minute. And if they don't do a Povetkin versus Duhapis, right? When Povetkin got dope versus Stiverne, and they only had 24 hours and Duhapis was there for the fight, maybe you don't want to do that. Now, I would hope that they bring Demetrius Andre in. Demetrius Andre, he just fought at 160, so he can be at 168 and come in to take over for Billy Joe Saunders. But why would Billy Joe Saunders not want to fight? Okay, get to it in a second. But those 70,000 people that might come is because you would feel what it feels like. Hey, man, I done brought my family at the last minute, and I, you know, this happened to me. And that's what has to happen to people on planet Earth. Stuff has to happen to them first before they feel it. I've been to fights before. I was in Manchester. I went to the David Haye versus Tyson Fury fight. They didn't have it at the last minute. You know, I just enjoyed Manchester a couple of days, right? Things happen like that. You know, I was upset at the time because I thought David Haye was about to do him in, right? But unfortunately, it didn't happen. I'm way in Manchester someday, I'm with her. But whatever, right? Those people would have to feel that. Then they would start fathoming what did Canelo do to make Billy Joe Saunders go home. Listen, one thing is, y'all 70,000 people that's in there, then when they did the contract, it wasn't about that. So Billy Joe Saunders is not getting the money from some of those 70,000 people that are coming, which I think he should. That's been a gripe that he's already kind of swept under the rug. But that's a gripe, don't you think? Right? Billy Joe Saunders is a mover in the ring. Right? The ring is supposed to be 24 feet. They're trying to do it at the last minute, put it down to 18 feet. 18 feet. And Billy Joe Saunders' father has said several things. He said, first of all, they're trying to cheat us at every opportunity. But the other thing is, we're not budging on this one. Right? We're not budging on this one because that's way too far. 18 feet ring is amateur, right? That's for amateur. And we're not doing that. right? Now, there's other things you're hearing about glove controversy, right? That Canelo does some things on his hand wraps, wrap hands be wrapped before people come in there. And this is kind of kind of funny, ironic, because people were thinking we better watch Billy Joe Saunders because he's highly affiliated with Tyson Fury, who we've know has been tampered with his gloves on several occasions, right? So when you're looking at all that together, right, you're looking at, wow, they're worrying about gloves too. So there's a whole lot of things when it's going on with Canelo Alvarez. It's like when it goes on with Canelo Alvarez, it's like Canelo Mafia. It's like no one does anything about it. Now, Tyson Fury's even weighed in, right, on through Instagram. He's come in and said, "Hey, man, Eddie Hearn, you know, first of all, Eddie Hearn's the promoter for both of them, Canelo and Billy Joe Saunders, at least for these fights." And he's like, "You got to be effing fair," right? Talking about he's not being fair to Billy Joe Saunders, right? Now he's weighed into it. That's funny, because it's ironic that he's talking about fairness. But people don't do anything when it comes to Canelo. Canelo just had an interview, and somebody asked him about Billy, about Demetrius Andrade, and he gets an attitude about it, right? Oh, he ain't fought nobody. You find somebody right now who has less accolades than Demetrius Andrade in the boxing community. Now, people out there on the internet who's trying to protect Canelo and all that, they're saying silly things. But everyone knows that Demetrius Andrade is a tick better than Billy Joe Saunders, and damn sure better than Roy Fielding and Admiral Yildirim, right? And Callum Smith, and he's been in your division for two divisions, 154 and 160, and he was the key to you being undisputed at 160 pounds. And you didn't fight him. He was so not deserving. He should have been deserving right there. There's a guy, if Yildirim was that guy that could have had Canelo to be 160 pounds undisputed, he would have fought Yildirim for that. He would have fought Samaretta for that. He would have fought Steve Rose for that. He would have fought anybody for that except for Demetrius Andrade. Period. And maybe a Charlo. He's running around here with a franchise belt, which is the Charlo belt, because Charlo is didn't want it for unified your mandatory. So these are the questions that people don't ask Canelo. So somebody asked Canelo, I think Brian Custer, and he got an attitude, made all kind of funny faces. What about Demetrius Andrade and you fighting all these other guys that are not as good as him? Right? How do you know? And here's the point. He can still say that after 6 years. After 6 years of Demetrius Andrade following him around, he can still say that. That's the kind of thing. That's why, I'm not watching the damn fight with him and Billy Joe Saunders anyway. But it would be very good to see Billy Joe Saunders walk away from this fight just to take a stand. I know it's hard to say because you're giving up millions and things like that. But if someone doesn't take a stand against these guys, I sat there and watched Demetrius Andrade versus Leon Williams, and I saw after the fight that Eddie Hearn mentioned he started talking about Charlo. Instead, he promotes Canelo and Matchroom right now, and Canelo's at DAZN and all that, and Demetrius Andrade is his boy. He got him under contract, and he wouldn't say that Canelo has not fought this guy. He wouldn't say that Canelo didn't fight him at 160 when he could have been undisputed. He didn't say that he can't get Canelo to even think about Demetrius Andrade. Canelo can just call Demetrius Andrade boring, and that's it. And everybody would just say, "Yeah, he's boring." Is that that's the one we're going with, y'all? Is that the one we're gonna be saying? Okay, cool. Yeah, he's boring. Like a champion can be boring, right? A champion that's been champion in two weight divisions and undefeated can be boring, right? And we're gonna just go with that? Man, it's patronizing to me. I don't really like to even really talk about it, to be honest with you. But at the end of the day, they're messing up this ring. Billy Joe Saunders might leave, and let's hope he really does. I really hope that he just leaves the damn fight. If they're gonna mess with him about the ring, if they're gonna do something with the gloves, you don't need no cheating. If Canelo Alvarez is what people say he is, he's like number one pound for pound in the face of boxing. It's just because that's the best face you want up there, right? But stop asking him to cheat. And avoid fighters that are good, and we're just navigating him through all kind of stuff. I don't want to make it totally a Canelo video only, but we let 155 pounds being heavier than who you fight and navigating through 160, 154 is way too dangerous with Lara, both Charlos and Andrade. I'm not gonna fight Andrade for the WBO. Oh, Andrade got stripped. Leon Smith is the title. He has a title now. Cool, I'll fight him. right? Oh, at 160, I'm up here before they there. I want to unify. Oh, wait a minute. Now, Charlo is my mandatory. Demetrius Andrade, I can beat for undisputed. No, I'm not going to do this. Let me go up to 168. Benavidez gone? At once, what, at the WBC title? Benavidez gone? Y'all stripped him? Can I go up there and fight Yildirim for that? Okay, cool. Now, Billy Joe got the other one, and Caleb Plant got the other. Okay, I'm going to be undisputed at this weight right here. And then ban Billy Joe Saunders from fighting Andrade in February, banning Caleb Plant from fighting Benavidez before, because mess around, Benavidez could win and Andrade could win, and then you got to fight Andrade and Benavidez to unify that division. And that's what he don't want to, and it's obvious. It's obvious, people. That's not who should be the face of boxing for anybody, right? You have to make him have the same standards as everybody else, and that's just fair. So let's hope those 70,000 people go on over there and somebody walk out of there and Billy Joe Saunders walks out at the last minute, because you don't have Bam. So maybe it is something has to happen to you so you can realize, well, I'm sick of following somebody who, damn it, the ring, what did y'all sign for? Did you sign for 24-foot ring? Then damn it, it should be a 24-foot ring, foot ring, and it shouldn't be nothing else. I don't care how much I like this fighter, but now I done drove my family way down here, and he's tripping about a ring, trying to cheat on the ring on the guy that already done traveled from Britain, right? Then people will start probably focusing if they lose time or something like that. But anyway, we're gonna leave it right here. Domo Sports Talk Worldwide, and I'm up out of here, y'all.